Students, your test day, it is Monday, right? So that means next Monday, you will be having your first revision test. So we have enough time to complete the syllabus, which is included in the first test, right? I have shared also with you the division of the syllabus. Test one is your first flight, right? And the grammar topics, which we have your voice and narration and determiners, right? For your second test, you have the second book. Which book is that? Yes, Footprints Without Feet. So those three chapters plus your subject, verb, agreement, poems would be in the first test only, no? It's written in there, is it? No, just check it again. I've sent. Is it written there? I just please check it again because I am very sure poems are in the first test only. Okay, it's written there. Fine, we'll add the poetry also in the first test. Yeah, first test poetry. And so never mind, we'll discuss them. We'll do that, okay? And of course, you're going to get your grammar questions, which are going to be your multiple choice questions, right? Even from your writing skills. So you have narration, you have voice, you have your subject, verb. Revision test is on Google Form. Yes, revision test is on Google Form. Okay. So now all of you, can you see the screen? Revision test is on Google Form. Right? Clear? Happy? Now look at this here. And we'll just do these questions. Right? I hope you can read. So those in the class, please look at it. You may think it is funny, but I can't. Yes. Narration. A, B. I have shared this also with you. Right? So if you have taken time to look at it, you will know that what the questions are. But we don't take out time to see that. So all of you now note down. I hope you can read. You may think it is funny, but I can't. Then why should I treat your eyes? I believe illiterates too need to see. So this is a dialogue between a doctor and a patient, right? Now we, as you might get multiple choice questions here, right? And you would have to identify the correct answer. But to identify the correct answer, you should know how to write the correct answer. Yes, are they, sit straight, please. Sit straight. Take out a notebook. The doctor told the patient what? Completed. The doctor told the patient, I hope you can read. Can you change it into indirect? That he hoped he could read, right? You can will become could. You would become he, right? That he hoped he could read. Okay, very nice. You may think it is funny, but I can't. The patient said that my think it is funny. Funny, but he could not. Okay. Then the doctor, then why should I treat your eyes? What kind of a sentence is it? Interrogative. We don't use that. We use if, whether, asked, inquired, isn't it? So the doctor then inquired, or the doctor asked the patient. Why means why? Why should I treat your eyes? Why should he treat his eyes? Then will also come. Where will then go? Why should he then treat his eyes? All right. Oh, fine. Correct. I believe illiterates too need eyes to see. Then what did the patient reply? He believed that illiterates too need eyes to see. So, right. So whether you can read or write, but if your eyesight can become weak also, even if you're an illiterate, it's not only if you're doing too much of reading work, only then your eyesight can become weak. So he's saying that whether you're literate or illiterate, you need to get your eyes checked, or anybody can have a problem with their eyes. Okay, yes, once again, people here in the class, let's do the next one. That's what I should be doing from your book, but because you always come up with excuses. Where can we meet tomorrow? So this is a conversation between Anoop and Atul. Write down, where can we meet tomorrow? Write on the first one. Where can we meet tomorrow? I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Where can we meet tomorrow? I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Are you going to be busy? Are you going to be busy? Yes, I will be traveling tomorrow. Yes, I will be traveling tomorrow. And Hardik is writing so nicely. I can see his neat handwriting from here. First is, where can we meet tomorrow? I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Are you going to be busy? Yes, I will be traveling tomorrow. Okay, so this conversation is between Anoop and Atul. Anoop asked Atul, where can we meet tomorrow? Where we will become they. Where they could meet the next day, the following day. Remove the question mark. I may not be able to meet you tomorrow. Atul replied that might not be able to meet him the next day. Very correct. Then Anoop asked, yes, whether or if he was going to be busy. Very good. Atul replied, there are two parts. Yes, I will be traveling tomorrow. Yes, will become. Atul replied in the affirmative, right? And said that he would be traveling the next day, right? So remember that. Yes. I cannot meet you, right? So two parts are there, and we have to make sure that both of them are done. And yes, so I can give a statement here. I can give you four options. Now remember here, when we change an assertive to indirect, what are the things that you have to remember? What are the things you have to remember? Removing inverted commas. We use that, right? And of course, only if the reporting verb it is there in the past, only then. Otherwise, says, will say, right? So accordingly, you have to remember, fine? Then, yes, so all the things that change, we have the change of pronoun, we have the change of tense, we have the change of position, okay? And the corresponding past tense, it is there. So if it is simple present, it will become simple past. Right, if present perfect would become past perfect. Present continuous would become past continuous. Okay, so you have to remember these little things. Now, when it comes to interrogative, things are a little different. What are the major things that you have to remember? One is there is that we're not writing. Okay, how do we introduce the reported speech? With if, whether, asked, inquired, right? Why, where, when you have the WH questions, how, right? Then, of course, the removal of the question mark at the end. So when I rewrite that sentence in the indirect form, I will not put the question mark. One thing is there, if your question is there in interrogative, you look at the options, is a question mark, then that is not the correct answer. Even if it is written correctly, everything is correct. Okay? But if the question mark is there, then it is wrong. So you have to keep these little things in mind when you identify the correct sentence. It appears to be easy, but there is a lot to be done. Okay? So, right, when I discuss with you the other, I tell the various forms also. So for grammar, we just can't have the other things here. So have you got the test done, doctor? Have you got the test done? Karna, no, I have not. Get them done today itself. Okay, right here. Now look at this. Mother, you seem so tired. Take some rest. Let's write it down for the students in the classroom. Those who are at home, please solve it. Yeah, keep your answers ready. You seem so tired. Take some rest. Next sentence, Suraj. I can't think of relaxing. I have lots of homework to do. Please write down the answers at home also. Rahul, you should not take so much of stress. Write down, Rahul, you should not take so much of stress. Suraj, don't worry. Please give me a hot cup of tea. Suraj, last line. Don't worry, please give me a hot cup of tea. You should not take so much of stress. You should not take so much of stress. Okay? Last is, don't worry, please give me a hot cup of tea. Have you written? Now let's start. First is, mother said to Suraj that he seemed so tired and advised, very good, take some rest. Is it an order? Is it a request? Is it an advice? Elders give advice, isn't it? Yes, or a suggestion. Suggestion would be like, of course, and advised him to take some rest. Suraj replied that he could not think of relaxing and added that he had lots of homework to do. Absolutely correct. Rahul. Yes. What did Rahul say? You should not take so much of stress. Rahul suggested, yes, that he should not take so much of stress. Suraj, don't worry. What is this? Don't worry. Yes, Suraj told them not to worry. Yes. And requested to give him a hot cup of tea. Okay, it's tea, you made it coffee, never mind. Right, correct? Yes. And students at home, yes, he recommended, he suggested to take, actually advised would be the best one. Yes, let's look at the next one. Is this clear? I know the problem is that all the answers are also given here, isn't it? Oh my God, that is a big, big problem. So never mind, let's see. Did you see my new umbrella? Isn't it fine? Yes, it is. Did you buy it from the mall? No, your father has brought it for me. So Mary asked her son, Tony. Yes, come on. This is for those at home. That the first question is not, have you seen my new umbrella? Isn't it fine? So Mary asked her son, Tony. Have you seen my new umbrella? If he had seen her new umbrella, right? Isn't it fine? And isn't it fine? What would that be? There are two parts. Isn't it fine? She further wanted to know. Interrogative, isn't it fine? Yes or no questions? Isn't it fine, right? So we have if or whether. Yes? Yes or no? Yeah. So here and asked or wanted to know whether if it was a fine one. Tony agreed. Yes, it is. Did you buy it from the mall? Yes, it is. Did you buy it from the mall? Tony agreed that it was and asked, what is the next one? Did you buy it from the mall? Asked if buyed or that? Bought. Bought. So remember your verb forms. There's no thing as buyed. Bought. Right? We had or if she had. He's asking her, no? If she had bought it from the mall. So bring, what will bring become if we have bring? Brought. Buy will become bought. Okay? Right. So these are the little things that we need to remember. So we get confused over here. Next is, yes. No, your father has brought it for me. Brought it for me now. Yes, so she replied in the negative and said that, your father has brought it for me. That his father had brought it for her. Very good. My offline students are very good, you know. They're giving wonderful answers, right? And as for the online ones, what's happened to them? What's happened to them? I don't see any response from you all. We're lazy, aren't we? Yes. Because you have everything right here on the screen in front of you. Actually, right, fine. I didn't get time. I should have hidden the answers for you all. Wait. Okay, Jay said, Vipul takes exercise daily. Choose the correct option. Jay said, Vipul takes exercise daily. Jay said, Vipul will take exercise daily. Jay said that Vipul had taken exercise daily. Jay said that Vipul takes exercise daily. Jay said that Vipul takes exercise daily. Takes, it's a habit. Right, it's a routine. So it'll be like that only, okay? Yes, correct. So which option is the correct one? Takes. Taked, there is no word. It would have been took also, is there? Right. He said man has two hands. He said that man had two hands. He said that man have two hands. Yes. He said that man has two hands. And he said that man had two hands. He said that man has two hands. Right. And otherwise, of course, here. I have a pair of shoes. You have a pair of shoes. They have a pair of shoes. We all have a pair of shoes. But he has a pair of shoes. She has a pair of shoes. So remember, as we do that, we have to remember your is, am, are, was, were, has, have. This is, you have to remember your subject, verb, agreement also. Okay? Right? And of course, here when we're doing a narration, the subject does not change. It's in voice that the subject changes. But when we change the tense also, you're changing that. So you have to make sure that you write the verb also correctly. These are little things that we remember. Okay, the doctor said to the patient, give up smoking. The doctor said to the patient. What kind of a sentence is it? Is it assertive? Is it interrogative? Is it imperative? Imperative. Doctor said to the patient. Is it going to be an order? Is it a request? Is it a command? Advice? Advice. Fine. The doctor said to the patient, give up smoking. The doctor advised the patient to give up smoking. Simple, because he's telling him something, right? Okay. So once again, we are doing about a suggestion or an advice here to give up smoking. So B part is the correct answer. Yes. Raghav said, I have my own choice. Raghav said, I have my own choice. Raghav said that he had his own choice. Raghav said that he has his own choice. Raghav said that he has his own choice. Raghav said that he has his own choice. He has or he have? He has. He has his own choice. Yeah. So I have my own choice, right? So he's telling his decision. Janki says Ram is very wise. Ram is very wise. That Ram is very wise. That Ram was very wise. Or that Ram will be very wise. Is that Ram is very wise. So that would be there. Okay, fine. Any doubts, any questions? Yeah, correct, correct. Okay, fine. Yes. So my online students have also woken up. Right.